In the first round of the playoffs, after a game between the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Washington Capitals, Mike Babcock was seen with a whiteboard behind him keeping track of different metrics for all of his lines and players. Amongst these metrics was Corsi, zone entry, zone denials, block shots, puck recoveries, all of the metrics you'd expect in today's game. But what was most interesting of all was that he had a section in the top left of the board titled Heavy Shifts. This got everyone on social media talking and speculating about what exactly a heavy shift was, because if Mike Babcock's coaching staff was keeping track of it, then it must be pretty useful. That's when one of the faces of the hockey reporting Mount Rushmore, Elliot Friedman, dug deep and found the meaning of a heavy shift for us laymen. And so, according to Friedman, a line gets a +1 in the heavy shift category when they pin the other team in the other team's own defensive zone for a significant amount of time. They'd also get a -1 if the same happens to them. These numbers are then compared and added to the team total. As we can see in the picture, the Maple Leafs total for the game was 9-4, meaning 9 heavy shifts for and 4 heavy shifts against. What isn't known, however, is what can be categorized as a significant amount of time, since this is one of the main requirements for a heavy shift to be recorded. What we can assume, however, is since an NHL shift lasts about 30 seconds, a heavy shift could be anything upwards of that number, with at least one failed exit, multiple shots on goal, and at least one puck recovery. As an example, it would be fair to assume that almost every Sedin shift in 2011 could have been considered a heavy shift. Search up Vancouver Canucks the shift for a perfect example of this. I'll provide the link in the description because I think it's a great example of, this is a really heavy shift to this example. But again, it's hard to know the exact specifics behind the requirements of a heavy shift being recorded, since all we have is this one photo of Mike Babcock just having a good time in front of a whiteboard and some words from an NHL insider on the subject. So, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I found the topic kind of interesting, and I hope you did too. Again, hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you around.